Everyone, Ken here, your Thrifty Apprentice, and in today's video we are taking a first look at, we will be unboxing, swatching, and doing a painting demo with the Paul Ruben student grade watercolor set. I happen to be a pretty big Paul Ruben fan. I've tested and tried quite a few of their products over the past couple of years, and I've been pretty pleased with it. So I picked this set up. I gifted this set. It's been so long ago since I received it, I honestly do not remember, but I'm finally getting around to getting it cracked open so we can test it, look at it, review it, all those good things. So a little back history, just in case you don't know, the Shanghai Owin Art Company, Owin's Art Material Company, who is the company that produces Paul Ruben's paints, was founded in 1998. So they've got about 20 years of market validation at this point, testing and trying and trying and producing many, many, many different products. They produce watercolor paints, different mediums like your varnishes and the different oils like sunflower seed oil and things of that nature for oil paintings. Of course, they produce oil paints and brushes. They produce oil pastels, soft pastels. They have different types of papers and books, from sketch paper to watercolor paper, watercolor postcards, illustration paper. So they are a pretty robust all-around company that has existed for a little over 20 years now, so about two decades, right? So, and I've been pretty happy with their products. I've tried and tested, and I pulled a few of them just so we could take a quick glance, really quick. Now, the least favorite of the ones I've tested so far, now this one is only available in the Asian market. This is the Paul Ruben Candy Colored Watercolors. This was a gift that was sent to me by a viewer to try out, just to see what I thought. I think you can get these on AliExpress, if you know, and I'll try to remember to link the review for all of these in the video description. But they were okay. I mean, they're more of a novelty palette, not colors that you would necessarily use on a regular basis with painting. Well, not with the way I paint anyway. So not my favorite of the ones I've tested and tried so far, but pretty cool. There is the Pretty Excellent set, which is made by the Owin Art Company. Now, this is not a part of the actual Paul Ruben's line, but it is produced in the same factory along beside Paul Ruben's by the Shanghai Owin Art Company. So they have really super high transparency. This is actually one of my top recommended suggestions when it comes to student grade paints. Really great product. The veil between them being student grade and professional is really kind of thin, in my opinion. That's my opinion. And then, of course, my favorite of all of them that I've tried so far is the actual Artist Transparent Watercolors by Paul Rubens. This is their original 24 watercolor set. Beautiful paint set. One of my top five of the professionals I've tried so far. Love these. Very transparent. Very easy to use. Not necessarily a traditional feel. They have more of a modern feel to them, but they just feel so down to earth, so to speak. Love those. So I was really excited to try these paints out. So let's jump into this and get to cracking. We're a little ways into the video now. So we are unboxing Paul Ruben's 24 colors solid watercolor paint. There is a lot of Chinese characters here. Shanghai Owin's Art Material Company. And that is pretty much the front of the box with Paul Ruben's logo in there. You flip the box over on the back and it simply says 24 color solid watercolors paint. Now this is their student grade paint. So we're going to keep our expectations at student grade paint level. Let's see if I can get this tape off here without damaging my box, which, you know, I love to do. All right. Throwing scissors at myself. Don't cut your fingers off throwing scissors at yourself. So we are gonna see if I can go ahead and pull that on out. All right, so the tin itself is inside a cardboard sleeve inside the box. And here we have our palette. Oh, that's okay, keeping that journal making. Yes. So here we have our palette. You have a beautiful blue palette, actually. It's not as shiny as I expected. It's got sort of a matte. It's shiny, but not quite as shiny as I expected. The back of the palette does have a holding ring. But this is a pretty large palette to be like painting on the go with. So let's see here. We'll pop it open. Can I get it up? There we go. Opens pretty easily. It actually opens pretty easy. There's a little divot here that you just slide your finger into. Nice. Okay. So, whoa. This feels familiar. This feels very familiar. Okay, let's see what we got here. Paul Ruben, that overlay, I've seen that before. Okay, so Paul Rubens, here we have, and this is the exact same brochure from the Paul Rubens paints. This is the same brochure from the Mailing Pretty Excellent paints, of course, with that line of paints in it, but same pictures are being used in the brochures across the different lines of paints that's produced by that particular art company. And I'm guessing this is giving you the full range that comes in. How many paints do we have here? It's quite a few of them. There seems to be a lot of colors. If this is all colors in the student grade range, and here we have color names. Well, I'm assuming we have color names because that's going to be in Chinese characters. We do have pigment numbers, okay? And we have stock numbers for the company for the color. All right. That's on the brochure. It is pretty much all in Chinese, so. But you do get the color stock numbers. You get the pigment numbers on there. So that's really good. Now here we have a swatch sheet. Again, everything is in Chinese, so I can't read any of that. This seems to be like a mixed media paper. It's pretty thin, but I do feel some sizing. So I would say this is a really super thin watercolor paper, but it feels like a mixed media paper. But here you have the color number. Oh, well, we have color names here. Okay, so this overlay. The overlay gives you the color name, the light fast rating, and the color number. It will look to me as if though what we have here is color name, light fast information, and the color number for the company as far as this line of paints is concerned. I don't think there's any pigment information. This seems to be the pigment information for their professional line of paints. But again, I'm gonna check all of it just to make sure by the time we get to the review video. So, show you that overlay. We'll just pull that up. Those paints are, they look a lot like, they sort of remind me of like a white night pen almost. Some of those are coming out of, yeah, like I can see the difference right away in the student line versus the other lines. And that's actually funny because this is their name student line, and the Pretty Excellent paints are actually a sort of a different line, and they look much better right out the box and out the palette. And I've already told you they performed amazingly. These, there's some cracking here in a couple of these already. some of the paint is, I wish I could pull that out so you could see that. I don't know if I can get this overlay. I'm trying to see, I'm working with it. I don't know if that overlay, okay, that'll come out. Cool, okay, so that raises out. Yeah, what is this? Piece of foam under there. So that's just, you know, if you didn't like the paints, I guess you could use a tin for something else or for other paints. Those are pretty deep pans, jeez. Look at that. So let me see if I can, okay, so you can pull it out. Yeah, that looks a lot like the, I mean, that's power, that's Chinese writing on the bottom, definitely. But that looks a lot like a white knight pen. Okay, yeah, so this is what I mean. Let me show you. You see how the paint is coming up over the top of the pen there? And that's not, you know, all of them are not like that. Some of them are, as you saw with the white, level to the pen. So there are some inconsistencies there with the, but this may be poured paint. I don't know. I'm not sure if this is poured or not. I don't think it is. I think it's machine cut. I can't be sure. It's just a little different for me. So yeah, there you have it. The paints look, I mean, they look like they might be transparent though, because those colors are, you know, a little deep in those, and those are really bright and vibrant. So I'm really anxious to test these out and see. So we're gonna swatch them, and then we'll, just trying to get that back in there. okay, we're gonna, there we go. We're gonna swatch them, and then we will do a painting demo with them and see what we think about them right offhand. Pretty decent color range. Some funny names. There's emerald green and sap green we're used to. Green deep, raw sienna. I mean, so some common names, regular blue, azure. So yeah, let's swatch these out. We'll swatch them out in a swatch book, and we'll do the swatch sheet, and then we will do a painting demo.
Now that we have the swatching under our belt, let me first apologize. I do believe that I forgot to press record during the glazing section of the swatching. So you guys probably only got to see maybe like the last row. But don't worry, we'll cover that more in the review when we get to that particular video for this particular set of paints. Now, I blocked off a section of paper here on the swatch sheet, and I divided it into three sections. That way I would have a sky, a mid-ground, and a foreground. And I'm going in with the color that's just called blue, which I believe may be phthalo. But they just call it blue. I can't really see the pigment number at this very second. And then I'm going to mix in ultramarine towards the top, keeping the heavier consistency of the darker color at the top. And you want to just bring the blue down, fading it and becoming lighter as you come towards the horizon. After I got those blues in the way I wanted, I took a paper towel. And here you'll see I'm just taking out some clouds. I just balled the paper towel up to one end and just using it to shape in some clouds into the sky just for a little bit more interest. Afterwards, I'm going to move into painting the foreground. The foreground is being painted with burnt sienna, a little mixture of burnt umber, and then I'm going to be using some salt in a really wet wash that has a lot of pigment in it in order to, one, see how the paints react to salt instead of the standard salt test, and two, to give me some texture in the foreground to, you know, kind of give the impression that there is sand there. Now, I am painting on Canson XL 140-pound cold-press acid-free paper. I am using Creative Expression Golden Tagline brushes by Creative Mark from Jerry Autorama. Of course, you can get Canson XL paper pretty much anywhere. It's a okay, decent student grade budget paper that you can find in most of your local discount stores, big box stores. It's going to give you okay results. I mean, it's not 100% cotton, but it's definitely not the worst paper you could possibly use. Now, when I decided to put in the foreground, I took that burnt sienna and that burnt umber mixture out into the water because I wanted to give the impression that the bank or the beach did kind of disappear into the water and that the water itself ran up on the beach. So I did use burnt umber to add in much darker areas into the sand. I wanted to add in shadow, and then I also wanted it to appear that some of that sand was wet. As we all know, when sand gets wet, it tends to take on a much darker shade than all of the sand that's around it. Afterwards, I moved in to paint the water, keeping in mind that whatever colors you put in your sky, you would want to reflect them in your water because that's typically how it would work in nature. So I took the blue, laid down my first layer, gave it time to dry. Then I went back in with ultramarine in order to lay down the shadow areas or the depth of the water. I was sure to skip over some areas, not to paint everything. I wanted some white to come through. That way you would have appearance of light in the water, have a little glistening. However, there are several ways to do that. If by chance you should happen to paint all of your water surface area and cover everything with color, you can always go in to scrub some of that back and use a paper towel to lift it out. Or you could possibly even use like a white gel pen, bleed proof white acrylic paint, a white crayon, a white water soluble crayon. All of these would probably be okay methods in order to add light back into the area if you should paint over it completely. Now here, I'm just kind of going back and forth, making sure that I have the saturation and colors that I want. I sort of went outside of the little box that I drew. So I did go ahead and use my scrubber brush to lift that excess paint up, which was a lift test in all honesty, and it worked just fine. Was able to get that paint right on up off of the paper. So just from the little preliminary painting, I was able to see that the paints do perform well to salt as well as lift. But I will be doing those individual tests for the review too, just to be on the safe side. I thought the picture needed a little bit more interest. It seemed to be missing something. So I grabbed a mechanical pencil, and you'll see that I'm sketching in some sailboats that all have their sails shaped a little different. The farther out towards or up towards the horizon line, the smaller I made the boats so that it would appear as far as distance that that particular boat was far away from us on the shore looking out at it. And then the other two boats I progressively moved lower than the horizon line, closer to the foreground so that they would appear closer. Just keep in mind that as those items come closer to the bottom of the page and further away from the horizon line, those objects are going to get bigger because they would technically be closer to us. Wanted to throw in some rocks, so I sketched in some rocks with my pencil, and now I'm just kind of going back here and painting in everything. Now this first rock, the one that's closest to us, it has quite a few colors mixed in it. Of course, I mixed burnt sienna and ultramarine, or in this case the light ultramarine, to make a dark gray tone. That's what I'm using for shadowing. And that rock also has some yellow ochre, some raw sienna, some burnt sienna dropped in it. Just any of the tones that I had used in the composition. And then one or two tones just to kind of brighten it up, make it appear a little bit different than the sand did. As far as the rest of the rocks and even the sailboats, I'm really just using the mixture of burnt sienna and light ultramarine in order to paint those in. You know, kind of silhouette them in, so to speak. You're not going to really see too much definition of those particular items that are on the water, considering how far they are from us, from the perspective that we're painting. Hopefully that makes sense. Yeah, I think it did. Okay, so yeah, I'm just going to get all of this done, get all of this, you know, sketching. I'm going back and forth with that gray tone that I made, making sure that I have enough shadowing depth in my rocks, enough shadowing on the sailboats. That way you could see the entire outline. When you don't have to paint much, your mind is going to do the work. With that rock in the foreground, I did use the credit card scraping technique in order to scrape some of that paint around. Now what that will do is it's going to mar the surface of the paper and give it texture. Just keep in mind, when you do that, you can't go in reverse, you can't take that back. Once you damage that paper, it's damaged. There's no like fixing it. So be sure that you want to use the credit card to scrape in those different designs. Just know that it is a wonderful technique, and it lends to like crazy realism when you're doing your rocks. So here I'm gonna throw in some birds in the sky. I'm just adding a few more elements to it, as if though it didn't have enough, considering the fact that the painting was already so small. I'm just trying to make sure that I do complete compositions when I paint, instead of just doing one item. Now here I'm adding back in some of the white with a white gel pen. You're going to see me hit the sailboats. You're going to see me highlight the rocks. Anywhere that I think maybe the sun may be glistening. And of course, with these high highlights like this, it would mean that maybe, you know, the sun is glistening off of water or some wetness that's on the rocks or on the sailboats. Just giving a little reflection, making sure we add that in. And now I'm just going to throw some shadows on the boats into the water. And that's pretty much going to bring us to an end for the very first composition that I painted with these paints. Stay tuned. We will be painting many more before the review is offered. See you guys on the other side. All right, friends. That brings us to the point where we have completed the unboxing of swatching, which I do believe I had a little mix up with the camera being off when I thought it was on doing the glazing layer. So my apologies about that. And I don't really like the painting.
Of course, I probably told you guys that in the voiceover as the demo was going on, but I don't know. You know, I'm going to save all my thoughts and opinions about the paints for the review. I just wanted to, you know, let you guys kind of walk through the introduction of the paints with me. So I just made a video of what I would normally do behind the camera, actually. So this is the painting that I was mimicking. I did this one back during, Inktober 2022. And I used ink, of course, for all of the little additional images. But the paints was Arteza watercolor paints. It was Arteza tubes. They're premium tubes. Now, I'm not the biggest fan of that particular paint set, but I actually do like the way this one came out better than, and you know, you never really paint a painting the same way twice. So, you know, it was just a difference in the moods and actually a difference in the products as well. Now here I used pen. This is all watercolor. This is all the Paul Rubens. So yeah, anyway, that brings us to an end. Thanks guys for joining me and you know, just kind of being artsy and going along with me as I did a preliminary look at the Paul Rubens 24 solid watercolor student set. I'm going to, of course, do a couple more paintings with these paints on a couple of other different types of papers, take some notes, do some other testing, color mixing, all that good stuff. And then eventually in a week or two, we'll be back looking at these with a review. So, you know, if you guys saw anything during the course of this video that you like, you found helpful, any information, any techniques, tips, whatever. If you like the video in any shape, form, or fashion, please give the video a thumbs up, guys. I really would appreciate it if you enjoyed the content at all. Please share the video if you would like. Remember that sharing is caring, and maybe there is someone else out there who would like to see this video or information. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed. I would really appreciate it. It's going to really help the channel grow, especially if you like the content. You can even hit that notification bell so you'll know when new content come out, or you can just come over to the channel and look forward, however you choose to do. But I would really appreciate it if you subscribe. You know, hey, I'm like TLC. I ain't too proud to be. I've heard some people talking about, I'm not going to ask people to subscribe. No, I'm going to ask you, you know, if you're enjoying the content, please subscribe, because it helps the channel grow. Yeah, thanks. And I would really appreciate that. Check us out on all the social media sites. Facebook, Instagram, TikTok. Video description is going to have a link to the Facebook sponsored group, or the Thrifted Princess sponsored group on Facebook, which is Paints, Pencils, Pastels, and Markers. Please feel free if you want to. If you are respectful artist or crafter who wants to be in a group where people just kind of support each other, laugh and talk and share, trying to get it more active, trying to get it more engaged, so come on over and join us. You can also check the video description for links for a lot of different things: the Etsy shop, most recommended product list for great quality products that are not going to break your pocket. And remember, as I tell you guys at the end of every video, just keep painting and crafting.